I'm Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Okay, so you want to get yourself a clip that you can create a keyline from. I'm just going to move my timeline to 2 seconds and drop a marker. So tap on the little marker icon or M on the keyboard. Change the color to orange, and that also sets the exact time. And then I'm just going to call this marker keyline snapshot, and then that way you know exactly where your snapshot was made. Then we're going to go down to our export and tap on snapshot. Now if I swipe in from my right, I'm going to be able to save this snapshot up onto my files. So tap share, save to files, and then I'll just call it astronaut snapshot. Always important you name things correctly, that you'll recognize where they are. And then we'll dump that into graphic assets. Right, oh, we put it into graphic assets, no, image assets, because at the moment it's an image. Tap save, move away. You tap on video assets, that'll take us back to our main folder view. Tap on image assets, and then we have our astronaut PNG. So if we tap and grab it, bring it down into the timeline, pinch out to expand the timeline, and then just stretch this right the way across the whole 10 seconds. And then again, go back to our keyline snapshot position and set it to 2 seconds. And then we'll bring it back in to, let's say, 4 seconds. That gives us animation there. It stops and freezes there and then continues there. I actually reduce this to 2 seconds, 12 frames, 2.5 seconds effectively. That looks pretty good. Now what we want to do is go to RStudio Pro and create our keyline or outline effect for the astronaut. We are now in RStudio Pro. So I'm going to go to files, new, from file. There's our snapshot. Make sure we're in the right place. Yes, we are. Tap on that and open it up. And what you want to do to start with is go to your lasso tool and then just as close as the edge as you feel comfortable. Work your way around. Just following the outline of the astronaut. And when you get to the feet, just come in a little bit and then stop there. And then we're going to go to the magic wand tool. Make sure I'm on the right selection tool. Let's just see, wrong selection tool. So it's going to be this one here. And you'll see if we just tap with the magic wand tool, which by the way has got a tolerance of 15, which if you're using Photoshop or Affinity Photo, usually the default tolerance is around about 32. So it's almost half that. And we just tap on the edge. You're not going to get this 100% perfect. As long as we're 95% of the way there, we can do a cleanup at a later stage. And if there's anything you can't see or get into, just zoom in and go in a little bit tighter. This just takes a few seconds to basically go along and to find your edge that you need. And as I've said already, it doesn't have to be 100% perfect because we can clean it up at a later stage. You see how that's come in there? What we can do is switch back to the lasso tool and go along and surround it, and then go to the add option on the inside and then just work along that edge. Then we can go back to the magic wand, keep expanding the selection right up to in between his legs. Probably going to have a similar issue, it's not too bad there. Again, back to the lasso tool, get the right selection edge. I always forget which is which, so don't be surprised if you've got to click on it a few times, or tap on it I should say, till you get to the right bit you want. It's going to be a little bit sus in here. We'll tap here. That one. Just gonna clean up this edge here with the soot and go here and on the outside and again. I tidied that up. That edge is a little bit sus, so back to the inside. You can do this as much or as little as you want to refine the edge. But it doesn't have to be perfect, and you'll see why in a couple of minutes. Again, I'm just going to run my lasso tool along the edge and up here. And it's personal preference if you want to use the lasso tool. Because I'm running the 2021 12.9-inch iPad Pro with M1 chip, you've kind of got a buttery smooth selection tool, which sometimes on the older iPad, for example, the 10.5-inch I was using up until a couple of weeks ago, wasn't quite as smooth. Let's clean that bit up. So you can either use the magic wand and tap, or you can just do what I'm doing, which is just neatly, or as neatly as possible, going around the edge and making selections. And if you don't want to watch this, I will put the time code up on the screen as to when I get this finished off. If you haven't seen an awful lot of selections being made before, it might be worthwhile just hanging around, seeing what techniques I'm using. Well, they're all going to be pretty similar. Let's point out, that looks pretty good. Do a little bit up here. Just a little bit chewed in here, so we'll go a wee bit wider. A bit too wide. Do Command Z. I'll work on the inside. It's easier. Right. Again, still on the wrong selection point. Yeah, that works. Okay, have we got everything that we kind of need? Looks like it. Okay, zoom back out. Set it to sort of a normal view angle. There's a selection that doesn't actually look too bad from this point of view. Then all you're going to do is copy and paste. So Command-C, Command-V, or up here, tap, copy, edit, paste. And you'll now see we have a layer with our astronaut. Now we don't actually need the layer below because we've already got that set up on LumaFusion, and we don't need the selection. So you can either go to select and deselect or Command D on the keyboard. And all you've got to do from here is highlight the layer, tap on effects, tap on edit effects, switch on stroke, tap on the more option, change the color to white. And you'll see the stroke edge starts to appear. I'm going to set the radius of the stroke to, I think, 9 pixels. Yeah, that looks quite interesting. And we're going to choose, I think, outside. Yeah, outside's going to work best for this. So it gives you a little bit more room. Now you'll notice we've got little dots and things going on. I'll show you how to get rid of them in a second. So we'll just close down the layer. We don't need that at the moment. And then we're going to move over to our erase tool. Zoom in, and you'll see all we've got to do is just erase the bits that we don't want, and they magically vanish. You can clean up the edge if there's anything rough and make it a bit smoother. And that's why the selection didn't have to be 100% accurate. So all I'm doing is just taking away any silly little lumps and bumps that kind of don't make sense to the way the key line has actually been produced. A little bit tighter here. That looks okay. Command Z on that. Go back a space, or use the little arrows in the bottom left hand corner if you want to purely be using the taps on the iPad screen. Nothing wrong with that. Need to clean up this edge a little bit more. That looks pretty good. You don't want to be too perfect with it. So remembering to keep to the whole canvas so that this astronaut ends up in the exact position you want him to be. And then we're going to go to File, and then normally I would use Quick Export, but I want to actually put it into my graphics file. So we'll go Export this time. Choose PNG, tap Next, and then tap on Save to Files. And this time, this is a graphic asset, so we're going to pop them in there. Tap Save, and that's them saved. And then I can just go File and Close, and then we can go back to LumaFusion. So if we hold down the Command key, if you're on the keyboard shortcut, and then the Tab key, you can just quickly switch it back. And then from there, we're going to go into our graphics assets, and there's our snapshot with the keyline edge. And you just want to tap and drag it down onto our third layer, and then expand it all the way across. We've got 2 seconds lead in. It then freezes, and it then moves on again. But how do we get the animation of the keyline effect? Well, that's actually really simple. Go to the front of the astronaut snapshot. Gonna tap on our little edit pencil, or press 1 on the keyboard. We're going to go to our cropping. Now I'm just going to reset everything just now. At the moment, we've got the original PNG outline, and we want to drop a keyframe at the beginning and tap invert. That gets rid of the overall effect. Then you want to come in, probably say 10 frames. Let's make it half a second, 12 frames. And from there, you can either use left to reveal, right, bottom up, out of the way, or is I'm going to do it top down. And then if we go and play it back, just tap on the beginning of the clip, press play. It's as simple as that. Let's see that in conjunction with the rest of the clip. Stops, there's the effect, and then it continues on its way. Now you'll notice the PNG has sort of washed out the astronaut a little bit. So you are going to have to go into your edit controls by tapping the pencil, and then you're going to go to your color presets or press 5 on the keyboard to get there. Tap original, you're going to give it a little bit more contrast and probably a little bit more vibrance just to boost the overall effect. I'm going to get back out of it. And there's the effect. And then it moves on. And that's us. It's a very simple technique. And it actually follows on from my previous video tutorial showing you how to do a text reveal. Because if you had been following that and you saw me hiding the text when it came to the gentleman running across the crosswalk, although I get pulled up for calling it a crosswalk because that's quite an Americanized thing. So if you're in the UK, the zebra crossing. If you're in America, crosswalk. If you had used this technique of inverting the outline or the text reveal, then you could have done it in one whole swoop rather than frame by frame. Once again, let's just play it through. Boom, done. The only other thing you could do at this point is add a little bit of a sound effect or whatever. I'll probably do that for the cold open, but it's the actual outline that we want to get right in the first place and animate it in. If you enjoyed the video tutorial, give it a thumbs up. If I've earned your subscription today, by all means subscribe to the channel. And once you've done that, don't forget to tap on the bell, and then that way you will get notified when my next video tutorial is coming out. And I will catch you on the next one. See you later.